Hello and welcome to the Troops of Teachers Virginia Center's virtual coffee house. I'm Charlie Foster. I'm the veteran liaison for Troops of Teachers Virginia Center. And today we're going to talk about study tips for the Praxis and the VCLA, the Virginia Communication and Literacy Assessment. Information for our study tips actually comes from Praxis and VCLA's official study materials, from participants who reported success with the tests, and from personal experience. I actually took the Praxis and the VCLA, so I would be able to give better advice to participants. The first step for taking the Praxis or VCLA is scheduling, and these tests are long. They take either 3 or 4 hours, and that's something to keep in mind when you're scheduling, is it's going to be a long test. You're definitely going to want to eat something beforehand, and you're also going to want to think about what time of day you operate the best. So if you're a morning person, you probably want to schedule that 08 Praxis or VCLA test. If you do better, you know, in the afternoon, that's when you really perk up and have more energy, then you might want to look at scheduling one after noon or after 12 o'clock. The Praxis test has more than 100 questions, the VCLA has more than 80 questions and an essay, and so these are really long tests, and that's what we mean. We say that it takes 3 hours to take these, and that's why, is because there's very, very many questions, multiple sections, and that's something that you're going to want to think about when you're planning, and that's definitely why you want to be sure to eat something, is because it just keeps going, and you think, how many questions do I have left? Anyway, you certainly don't want to be hungry while you're doing that, or you don't want to have something very important that you need to go do. I think it might be tempting to say, oh, well, I can finish this faster than most people. I do think it is going to take almost the full allotment of time to take these tests. Finally, if you want to take the test at a specific time or on a specific day, you may need to look at multiple sites. So both the Praxis and the VCLA have more than one test center that offer the test, especially if you're in a heavily populated area like Northern Virginia or Hampton Roads. So if you know you want to take it on Wednesday, for example, then you may have to look at multiple sites to find your test available on Wednesday. The same thing for a certain time of day. If you want to take it late in the afternoon, you might have to look at multiple different sites to find one that fits with your schedule. Praxis tests come with study companions, so you can actually find those on the test page at the top. It's a PDF, it's usually around 50 pages, and it's got general test taking info, but it also has info specific to the test. So it'll have sections and content areas that are going to be on the test, and that way you can actually zoom in and see what's going to be on there and study what specifically you feel like you need to refresh on. So for me, I graduated from my undergraduate program 9 years ago, which is getting to be a pretty long time, and so when I went and took the test, I really needed to refresh on a couple of small things, and I didn't even know that until I started narrowing down what it is that was going to be on this test. So I really did a first pass of studying by looking at the things I thought I needed to study. And that's true of the VCLA also, because I was an English major, I thought that I was barely going to need to brush up on anything. And it really surprised me, the in-depth questions that were on there. So you're definitely going to want to look at the study companion to see what it is that's about to be on your test. Praxis offers practice tests, and I highly recommend those. I have a theory that the practice tests are actually retired real tests because they're the exact same length. They feel exactly like the test that I went on to take. And so I think that they were administered in previous years and then used as practice materials for folks who are going to go take the test. So I think it really, really closely simulates the experience that you're going to have when you take the test. I also think it's valuable because while you're taking it, you can actually stop yourself and you can take notes and say, I really want to look up this area because I don't remember what this word means, or I don't remember this concept. And so you can be taking notes as you take it on things to go study. And so I really think it's helpful. It doesn't freeze your browser or anything like a computer-based test might, because it's a practice test. And so what I did is I had a Word doc open, and I actually just copied and pasted things that I was confused about for later so that I could go study them at a different time. One great strategy that I'm going to steal from a participant, thank you, Tony, if you're watching, is to study the wrong answers on your test, on your practice test. So you take a practice test, you find a question, you say to yourself, okay, I know the answer to this one, but you read the multiple choice options and you may recognize in those options that there is a concept you're not as familiar with. So you can actually go back and look that up, and his reasoning, the reason that he did that, for every question is he reasoned that it might be on the test. If it was offered as a possible wrong answer, then it's fair game. So it could be in play in the test that he went on to take. And I don't have to tell you that he got a great score. And so I thought this was a really valuable study tip. Another study tip that I borrowed from a student in my art history class long, long ago is to create a PowerPoint to serve as your flashcards. So I usually don't have index cards, but I do have PowerPoint on my computer. And so what I can do is I can put a concept or a question on the first slide, and then I can put the answer or solution on the second slide. So I can test myself that way by going through the PowerPoint and using it as a substitute for flashcards. For some reason, I really like designing those flashcards on PowerPoint, and it might be something that helps you too. The VCLA is a little different. It's got the test blueprint that you can review, and that gives you kind of an overview of what to expect on the test. They've also got sample questions. They've got sample answers and explanations about why those are good answers, and they have practice tests too. And so all of that I think is really helpful so that you're not surprised by what you find when you get into the test center, into the testing room, and start looking through the items that are going to be on that really, really long test. It's just nice to encounter that material beforehand. And so VCLA, like Praxis, makes a lot of that available to you on their website before you go and take the test. All right, so when you've scheduled the test and you've studied, then it's time to take the test. So on the day of, I highly recommend looking at your registration info to make sure that you know exactly when you're supposed to be there. Sometimes you're asked to come a little bit early to do kind of a check-in process before you get there. So you definitely want to know if you need to do that. You're not supposed to bring anything into the actual testing room, and they offer you a locker so that you can put your items in that locker. That's just a heads up that you're definitely going to have to leave things behind. So if you're not comfortable leaving it in a locker, you might want to lock it in your car. The other thing that I highly recommend is bringing a light jacket or a sweater into the test room. That is allowed, and sometimes it's cold and you need to warm up. Other times you're hot and you need to cool off. That's why having a light jacket or a sweater I think is better, so that in case you need to change the temperature because you're working so hard, because you're getting so many questions right that it's making you sweat, then you can actually make a small change and feel a little bit better, because it is a long, long test. So you also will get specific instructions about if you need to take a bathroom break or a break, then you raise your hand to have the proctor come over and they'll allow you to do that. If you are worried about the noise, there are headphones in the testing center at each station so they can cancel out the noise from other people taking other tests. Everybody in my test center was actually very courteous and they were as quiet as they could possibly be. I did notice both times that some people were taking different tests, and so one thing that might affect you because you think you're behind because people are finishing at different times, or they're typing a lot and you haven't even made it to a typing section. Well, there might not be a typing section because they might be taking completely different tests. So that's just something to consider. I would also mention that there is a timer up in the corner of the screen, and that'll let you know how much time you have left. If that's bothering you, you can actually hide that. Another feature of the testing systems is that you can flag a question and come back later. And so that could be something that you want to do. I also want to reiterate something that you're going to see in your test preparation materials, and that is guessing is good. So you do want to guess on these because you get points for right answers. You don't get penalized for wrong answers. So that is something that's explicitly stated on these tests. So you definitely want to take a stab at every question. You might want to flag one to come back to it at a later time, but definitely take a shot at each and every one. All right, so after you take the test, you're going to get unofficial results, and those are going to be a prediction, so they don't guarantee that that is your actual score. You will get official results a couple weeks later. You can identify where you want to send your official results to. For Troops to Teachers purposes, you can print it from the email that you get, and you can send that to us. You can also have it sent directly to the Department of Education. You can also have it sent to a school that you plan on attending, so you got lots of options for that. Finally, I just want to say that we have veterans, military personnel, Troops to Teachers participants pass these tests with flying colors every single week. So I am really looking forward to you passing and to you sending us your scores and for us to all celebrate success. So thank you for watching this video. Looking forward to hearing from you and working with you.